After doing George Michael Going to Town, I discovered a song that he sang also at the same concert in Paris. It will be attached, Going to Town, to this particular video because, as I said, George Michael also sang this, but I stopped myself and I said, I've heard of that song before. Lo and behold, what happened was I came across Sonata Maitreya, which is not the name of this particular artist I know him as. We all know him in my age group particularly. If you go back to the 90s, 90s kids, I'm an 80s kid, and I'm a 2023 kid. But if we go back to the 90s, Terence Trent D'Arby is the person that springs to mind. And I kept looking at the images of this thinking, God, he's very like Terence Trent D'Arby. So on my research, I discovered Sonata Maitreya is Terence Trent D'Arby. And the song Let Her Down Easy that George sang was his song. So I thought, why not feature this? Because I really enjoyed Going to Town, a cover song by George Michael that was voted the most popular George Michael cover song on Instagram by his fans. But if he's covered this song, I thought, let's go back and look at the original. It intrigued me. It's the first time I'm going to look at this. I loved Terence Trent D'Arby. I thought he was phenomenal, and he's still performing. Like many, many artists of the 90s, there's a revival in the 90s music. I don't think, like the 80s, people will ever get bored of the artists or the music. But Terence Trent D'Arby, let's go into a little bit of bio about the song. Let It Down Easy was a song written by Terence Trent D'Arby for his third studio album, Symphony of Damn, in 1993. It was released as the fourth single in 93 and reached number 18 in the United Kingdom. But everybody, Smash Hits, which was a magazine that included all the latest gossip, now you can get it online, but all, not Smash Hits, but that kind of thing. All, like, look at my channel. You went to Smash Hits and it gave you all the gossip about the stars and the songs they were going to release in the album in the 90s. And Alex Kadis from Smash Hits wrote, and she wrote, it's a wonderful, haunting, graceful ballad with beautifully phrased vocals to take your breath away. If you've ever been in love with someone older or younger, then this will break your heart. So before I break everybody's heart with that, Terence Trent D'Arby started his career as Sandhya Maitreya, but changed it and became the singer-songwriter we all knew and loved for songs like If You Let Me Stay, Sign Your Name, Dance Little Sister, and Wishing Well, all phenomenal songs. His earlier life, Terence Trent D'Arby was born Terence Trent Howard in Manhattan. His mother, Frances, is a gospel singer, teacher, and counselor, and Frances Howard married Bishop James Benjamin D'Arby, who became his stepfather and raised him. So he took his stepfather's last name and added the apostrophe. Now, I think no matter what this particular video, his original name incorporates, we'll always know this artist as Terence Trent D'Arby, one of the greatest writers, singers, and performers of all time. He truly was. Let's fast forward into his career. In 2022, he was featured on Calvin Harris' new love regenerator track, Lonely, a record which Harris recorded with Italian producer Riva Starr, with the vocals coming from the 1989's And I Need to Be with Somebody Tonight. So Maitreya has appeared in two films and in the miniseries Shake, Rattle and Roll, an American love story, in which he played the part of Jackie Wilson. His personal life is he formerly married Italian television host and architect Francesca Francone in 2003. They have two sons. And Maitreya also had a daughter from a previous relationship, London-based musician Serafina Simone. So that is you up to date with the song, what it's about. Let's listen, let's take the energy from this video, because the images are fabulous, I have to say. And let's analyze the lyrics straight after we listen to the 90s star that is still a star, Sandria Patria, who is known and loved as the Terence Trent D'Arby, and a song that George Michael covered. I can't wait to hear his version, but I prefer to listen to the original.
You're top man on the scene. You don't think life comes in between. But hey, she's just 17. She feels that she's a worldly girl. But man, you've been around the world. She is just some worried daddy's girl. Even though there's nothing I can say to cheat you in nature anyway, let her down easy. Her heart is on a dime. Let her down easy, and you'll grow up in time. In her strawberry eyes, the way she sees you signifies that she's susceptible to your velvet lies. But if you must lay her down, may a butterscotch glow be her dressing gown. And please do not lead her on when you leave town. Even though there's nothing I can say to cheat you in nature anyway, let her down easy, her heart is on the line. Let her down easy, and you'll grow up in time. She's a woman now, with a daughter to make her proud, in her crayon world of paper clouds. She still remembers you, the first boy that she gave it to, and she laughs at how little then she knew. Her daughter is 5, and her grandfather adores her, of course. Let her down easy, her heart is on the line. Let her down easy, and you'll grow up. In time.
I have to say, it's one of those songs that you look at and you think, why isn't music like this anymore? Senator Maitreya, you are the finest soulful singer that my ears, because when you listen to it, even in these old fashioned now earphones, it's eargasmic. You're simply one of the most intriguing artist, but on top of that, it's just the purity of your voice. It's just when you listen, you just come right down. And I have to say, as I sit here with my coffee that I had a little bit off beforehand, after listening, I'm still down. I took it to perk me up, so I better do something. Beautiful. Just a beautiful story. It really is. And it's part of the reason why I want to start featuring him a lot in 2023, because he's still performing and his voice is added to different things, remixed tracks. I just think he's worth remembering. Don't you agree? I think you do. But let's get into the lyrics now itself. "You're top man on the scene," he begins. "You don't think life comes in between, but hey, she's just 17. She feels like she's a worldly girl, but man, you've been around the world. She's just some worried daddy's girl, even though there's nothing I can say to cheat you and nature's way." Instinctively in the video, we get a third pair of eyes, and that is the guy that's looking at this young girl he admires, he's in love with, and she is just wanting to be the older girl. And there she is, trying to get the attention of what is considered rock and roll, hard, rough man, and she just wants to be that person he likes. She's just 17, she's still a daddy's girl, as it says in the lyrics, but there she is trying to be above her station, be the mature girl for her age, and go with the older guy. Something to talk to her girlfriends about, no doubt. And it happens a lot where the girl is doing everything she can to get that older guy. But he doesn't really want anything. There's a bit of a shuffle. She drops her book. And the guy that is in love with her from a distance tries to go forward, but his friends are encouraging him not to go get into a fight with, I would say, the other guy that she's trying to get the attention of. So it's all going on. It's a mixture of emotions. But even though there's nothing he could say, as he says in the lyrics, to cheat you and nature anyway, she is just some worried little daddy's girl. At the end of the day, she's his age. He sees her innocence, her yearning, her wanting. But if this older guy gets her, she's cheated. She misses out on youth, really, because she's going for something that's a lot older. And it doesn't always work out because it continues. Let her down easy. Her heart is on a dime. Let her down easy, and you'll grow up in time. So he's wishing from afar that if this guy does take an interest in her, that she'll realize this isn't a relationship for her. And she's going for a much older guy who's settled, who treats women like, I don't know, like sexually, but nothing more. And from that experience, if she does get rejected, he's wishing that she learns from that and then comes back to her old self, her young self, and picks somebody like him. He continues, "In her strawberry eyes, the way she sees you signifies that she's susceptible to your velvet lies." So straight away, that's in reference again to this particular guy she's chasing and she wants the attention of. A lot of girls who are young think going with an older guy, he's got a job, he's got money, he'll look after me, I'll have a better time with him, I'll be able to go out and do a whole load of things I can't do at the moment. But what happens is, if you're very young and the guy is very settled and he's not into relationships, you're just another number to him. You're nothing. You're a non-entity. You're empty. And he says that she's susceptible to the velvet lies, but he'll sweet talk her. He'll want to have his way with her. So he'll say what he needs to say to attract her. She's already attracted. Just like the bee going to the honey flower to taste the honey. He'll let her taste it, and then it's bye-bye. Because he continues, "May a butterscotch glow be her dressing gown, and please do not lead her on when you leave town." In other words, when he gets on his bike and rides away into the distance, he leaves behind this young girl who thinks she's got a future with him. And that is a very strong statement, because straight away I think of a coffin, a person lying in it in a white robe, and it's this girl. And in his mind, the guy that's in love with her sees that as well, that she will die. He wants her when she's emotionally crushed and she feels dead inside from being rejected, that it's a butterscotch dressing gown. And you know, that's the subtle color. That's butterscotch, is we all think of butter as tasteful. And you know, when he leaves town, that she's able to recover and go from feeling dead to becoming alive again, because he says, even though there's nothing that I can say to cheat you and nature's way. In other words, she'll be cheated, she'll be used. He said, and he continues with, let her down easy, her heart is on the line, let her down easy and you'll grow up in time. Wishing the same thing, that if she does get a broken heart, she learns from it. Then it goes into the video where he pulls up in the car. So he's obviously a guy that never forgot her, always kept the third eye on her. And he says, she's a woman now with a daughter to make her proud in a crayon world of paper clouds. Beautifully put. Because when you think of young children drawing images of mummy, daddy, the house and everything, it's beautifully phrased. And we see her being kissed by a guy going away. And it says she still remembers you, the first boy that she gave it to. In other words, she remember, he obviously was a guy that had, she was the first sexual encounter. But after they broke up and she was looking for an older guy, he never forgot that. That sweet puppy love, as we call it, still he embraced it. Because pulling up in the car, you see how beautifully the editing was done, where he just casually puts that eye on her to make sure she's okay. And there's the husband leaving, kissing her, going to work, and the five-year-old girl. But 5 years beforehand, he was the first person, the first boy that she gave it to. And she laughs at how little then she knew. Her daughter's five, and her grandfather adores her, of course. It makes you wonder why he says that. The grandfather adores you, of course. I wonder if that's in reference to himself, that he feels like the older, wiser person that's looking down on her, always keeping an eye, that eventually he'll be there for her to come to. I wonder, because it can be a dual meaning here. He continues, let her down easy, her heart's on the line, let her down easy and you'll grow up in time. So even with the husband and the life and the child she has, it questions you, doesn't it? Who's the father of the child? Did she become pregnant to the older guy, got married, and yet the guy that she was with originally still on the outside looks in, thinking, I wish she had turned around and came back to me. But it takes two people to get together. And I hope from that you've enjoyed my introduction to Sanada Maitre, who'll be featured throughout 2023, better known as Terence Trent D'Arby, singing Let Her Down Easy. I think I made the right choice. Instead of George, I enjoyed the original. Hope you did too. Like, subscribe, and comment. Talk to you soon. Take care.